Time to play with some clay. All right, I'm going to make fringe by hand instead of by the pasta machine, because sometimes it just doesn't work very well. And in this case, it didn't. So I found that he had a couple of ermine hanging and a ribbon hanging down from his shoulder. So, a red ribbon, by the way. Looks like he favored red. Anyway, that's... also, there is a... I don't know if it was beadwork or what, but there's a pattern on the front of his shirt. I don't know if I'm going to get that detailed, but I'm getting my studio straightened around a little bit better. Finally found my trash bags for my trash can. Anyway, I'm going to put my GoPro into its holder, and I think I got that right over here, and I'm going to mount it up here so I can show you what I'm going to do here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make fringe and for his shoulder. Flattened out some clay so I'd have the same consistency. I flattened it out in my pasta machine. I'm going to do it in sections. Alright, first set of fringe I'm going to break them apart so I've got some individual twists to them as fringe would have. Much better than the pasta machine. Fringe. I'm just going to take the fringe right up to the fur. Now, I don't know if he had several jackets similar to this, because one of them I saw a fur strip coming down on the shoulder, but I'm not going to do that on this because it's not in the photograph and I'm not going to guess at it. I want to take this one, twist it a little bit, and bring it over so that I break up the monotony of the fringe. I'm just going to continue making fringe. I'm going to bunch this bunch up like it's underneath the robe. Oops. Now, if I'm going to have fringe hanging out by himself, I'm going to have several so that they can cast it. Well, that certainly looks better than yesterday's. All right. I'm going to make the shirt texture just a little bit different than the texture surrounding it. Just to separate it. Added the fur collar to this. I'm feeling it's a much smaller piece of fur, so I'm just gonna cut back on it. I'm using the same tool I used for the fur on yesterday's video, and doing the same strokes, jabs and strokes, to try to replicate the texture I got in the other fur so it all looks the same. I'm putting some Ronsonal lighter fluid on the face to smooth out the rough areas. I'm certainly not done with the face, but I just wanted to get rid of some of these real rough areas. While I'm doing this, I just wanted to remind you guys that I have instructional DVDs that I put over 50 years of my experience into them, showing you how to do things and how to save your time doing a lot of stuff. The idea is not to spend 10 months doing something, but just spending a couple of weeks, maybe a month or two, but certainly not a lifetime doing. Although, I think Leonardo da Vinci, when he painted the Mona Lisa, it took years to do it. But that's because he wanted to perfect it. All right, that's going to be it for today. I'll see you next time when we continue the adventures in sculpting, so to speak.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right. See you next time.